Intro video, that's amazing.
I love my intro video, isn't it the best? So welcome to the Boat Show, everybody. It's another episode, another week. I believe this is Boat Show episode 11. And our special guest this week is going to be Solus Ludus. So Solus Ludus, you can say hi to everyone if you'd like to.
Fucking nerds.
Oh, we're starting off wonderful on the Boat Show today. We have a special guest, and what I mean by special, I think he's our first special guest on the Boat Show this week.
Hey, man, I got a letter from my high school the other day saying, hey, you want to come collect your special education papers? I don't even know why I got it. Oh, yeah, air quotes, I see how it is.
Oh, God, this show is going to be amazing today. Yeah, I don't know about you guys, but this is just the start of the show today. We haven't even got into the good stuff yet, so Solus is going to be our guest. It's going to be a blast. But as always on the Boat Show, the very first thing we have to do is we have to talk about the games that the guest has played, that I've played, and that you have played, dear viewers. So we're going to start with Solus. From last Saturday to today, what games have you played?
Tanks, Boats, Eve, and some terrible Japanese import games because I'm a terrible weeba nerd.
Terrible Japanese import games.
Yeah.
So tell us some of those. I want to hear what those are.
I went and played Catherine, and I'm thinking to myself, hey, this seems like a fun game, and then no fucking puzzles with the fucking ants. And I hate puzzle games, and I'm absolutely terrible at the game. It's kicking my ass.
The puzzles. Oh, man, I feel like that's my normal day, because if you've ever played RuneScape, they have puzzles.
That was my jam in middle school.
Yes, they have puzzles, and my girlfriend's on a RuneScape kick, and she can't figure out the fucking puzzles, so I have to do them for her. So she'll call me up and be like, excuse me, Bo, I have another puzzle for you. So yeah, I like puzzle games, but I'll never play RuneScape because of that.
No. You shouldn't play RuneScape because it's a worse game than Eve, and that is a bar to clear.
Yeah. Alright, so you played a bunch of Japanese import games. What is attractive about those games if you don't like puzzles?
Well, I mean, like, there's a lot of them that don't have puzzles. Like, you know, here's the thing, you play Persona 3, you're going around and, hey, look, it's Japanese high school shit, and then... Oh, look, they have to shoot themselves in the head to do things. No, I'm dead serious. This is like a plot point. Like, hey, look, we have an extra hour in the day. Let's go shoot ourselves, summon monsters, and beat the shit out of things.
I've never played it, but that sounds amazing.
It sounds amazing, but it really isn't. You really shouldn't play. I know, it's kind of disappointing.
I don't know how that would be disappointing, but... It says we because the world needed a pigeon-based dating sim.
No, if you've played that, and I have, it's amazing, and you should stream it.
What, the hateful boyfriend?
Yeah, it has a full boyfriend, it's amazing.
Oh, tell me about this. I have to hear about this.
Korean.
Korean? Okay, explain this one to me. I'm interested in this game.
So, you are, as always, a new transfer student into a pigeon high school. And... this is, like, basically, take your basic, shitty Japanese dating sim, and be like, hey, guess what? All the girls are now replaced with pigeons. Surprise!
What the fuck? Wow. Yeah, that's just... I don't even know what to say to the pigeon thing, man. Pigeons.
There's not much to say.
Fucking pigeons.
Yeah, there's also Akiba Strip, which is fun, which is literally go around Akibahara, you go and fight vampires, and to kill vampires, you have to expose them to the sun. And to expose them to the sun, you strip all their clothes off of them.
Japanese anime games in this chat.
Yep.
Wow, that is wonderful. Oh, man.
Yep.
Only on the boat show do we go into that topic.
Oh. I've tried
to watch people stream those games, and it just makes my eyes want to pop out my head. Like, I watched a girl try to stream a dating sim, and she was actually role-playing it so well. But imagine, instead of being a guy going after all the chicks, she was trying to pretend she was a lesbian going after all the chicks. And Rick it was man. Like, yeah, she was hot. It was hilarious, because her boyfriend in the background is laughing his ass off. Like, he can't keep a straight face, while she's seriously going, I'm going to get me a waifu. I'm just like, whoa.
You know what? I actually kind of miss living in Japan, because then you can go and play these games in arcades with a crowd.
Oh, man. So someone just asked, why is there a Mick video feed? Well, as you all know from last week, I'm officially now sponsored by Blue Microphones. You can see it right here. It's right here. It's a blue microphone. So I couldn't find a way to take this microphone right here and put it on this camera right here. So I took my other camera and I put it facing the microphone. So you get to see my cool microphone. It's so cool. I love this thing.
I'm not a good microphone. I'm just using the crap-ass piece of shit that came
with my microphone. Well, I gotta show you the one I had before if I could find it. I don't know where it's at. But it was one of those $5 ones you get online that was made of plastic and a piece of wire. And the only reason the plastic's there is to hold it up.
Oh, you mean like my old microphone that was now duct tape?
Yes, this thing has electrical tape. I could have cracked it three places because I thought that's how you pulled it out. Really, you just
broke it.
So I've upgraded. Yeah, so.
This is why we can't have nice things.
No, it's not. So would it be easier to put the picture of a blue microphone? No, you have to see that I have a. It's right. There!
Oh,
you have to
God.
See it. But no, for some reason, sponsors like seeing their products on the stream, so I figured I'd show it. So back to games. Would you like to hear what I played this week?
Sure, go for it.
Eve.
Did you dump... Oh, shit, so did I.
So much Eve this week. We invaded a region, for those of you that haven't been keeping up with Eve things. We went and invaded a region. We invaded, Providence, and so I have been busy so much right now with bombing stuff. Just bombing everything. Like today, we threw 5 bombs and went home. And I don't even think we killed anything. Maybe a Naga or something, but we just played a lot of Eve. Oh, by the way, Kismetier says hi, and he says Jessica says hi. Oh, man.
Freaking nerds.
Kismetier is amazing.
Do you not remember this from the one time you went to
Yes! Well, I've been to Madison twice now, haven't I? Once when I was fat, and once when I was skinny.
You might have been there before me.
Yeah, I went there once when I was fat, and then I went there once when I was skinny. And it was hilarious, the difference.
Was fat.
Okay, technically, I'm fat, but,
Boat, you collapse wormholes behind you.
So yeah, when it comes to games, that's literally all I've played this week. I was supposed to play a game with my girlfriend this week, but my best friend was in town. I mean, I played some PS3 games, but I don't want to talk about those. I was really bad at them, and I died a lot. It really sucks. Yeah, it was terrible. But yeah, so, dear viewers, all you lovely people in the chat, would you do me a favor and just spam the chat with the games that you play? Now, if I cannot talk about the games, I'm sure Solus could. Especially if it's Japanese waifu games. I'm pretty sure he has some expertise on the subject. So just list the games that you have. I mean, I did play Dark Souls yesterday, I guess. I forgot about
that.
Yeah, I extended my death streak to 21 more deaths, so... Soccer Cars! I played Soccer Cars.
I kind of want to play Soccer Cars, but I don't want to pay for Soccer Cars.
I got it for free, so I played it on the PS3. Yes. Borderlands pre-sequel, I hear they're making a movie about that game.
Really?
Yeah, Borderlands Lion Gate just bought the rights to it.
Huh.
Battlefield 4, I am terrible at that game because I try to suicide all the time. Eve and fuck Eve, a lot of Eve players. Metal Gear Solid Zero, Ground Zeroes. How do you have ground zeros? Is that like where you blow up the Twin Towers in each country, and then each country has their own Twin Towers?
Damn it, Bone! You said you wouldn't go there!
But they said ground zeros, so I'm thinking there's like multiple sites. Maybe he beats Hiroshima and Nagasaki, yo, ground zeros.
Yeah, take that. That's what you get for putting out the shitty waifu games.
Whoa. We haven't even got. Oh my god, we are 10 minutes into the stream, ladies and gentlemen, and this is where we're going. Woo! Right down the drain. It's just. Oh man.
Oh god, shit.
So, Duck Game. I tried Duck Game. I'm terrible at Duck Game. I quit Duck Game. That game must exist already. No, it actually doesn't. You can't nuke another country in any game I've ever played. They don't let you. It's not fair.
Well, you've never played Civ.
Well, that's different. I'm talking about, like a role.
Intro video, that's amazing.
I love my intro video, isn't it the best? So welcome to the Boat Show, everybody. It's another episode, another week. I believe this is Boat Show episode 11. And our special guest this week is going to be Solus Ludus. So Solus Ludus, you can say hi to everyone if you'd like to.
Fucking nerds.
Oh, we're starting off wonderful on the Boat Show today. We have a special guest, and what I mean by special, I think he's our first special guest on the Boat Show this week.
Hey man, I got a letter from my high school the other day saying, hey, you want to come collect your special education papers? I don't even know why I got it. Oh yeah, air quotes, I see how it is.
Oh god, this show is going to be amazing today. Oh. Yeah, I don't know about you guys, but this is just the start of the show today. We haven't even got into the good stuff yet, so Solus is going to be our guest. It's going to be a blast. But as always on the Boat Show, the very first thing we have to do is we have to talk about the games that the guest has played, that I've played, and that you have played, dear viewers. So we're going to start with Solus. From last Saturday to today, what games have you played?
Tanks, Boats, Eve, and some terrible Japanese import games because I'm a terrible weeb nerd.
Terrible Japanese import games.
Yeah.
So tell us some of those. I want to hear what those are.
I went and played Catherine, and I'm thinking to myself, hey, this seems like a fun game, and then no fucking puzzles with the fucking ants. And I hate puzzle games, and I'm absolutely terrible at the game of kicking my ass.
The puzzles. Oh, man, I feel like that's my normal day, because if you've ever played RuneScape, they have puzzles.
That was my jam in school.
Yes, they have puzzles, and my girlfriend's on a RuneScape kick, and she can't figure out the fucking puzzles, so I have to do them for her. So she'll call me up and be like, excuse me, Bo, I have another puzzle for you. So yeah, I like puzzle games, but I'll never play RuneScape because of that.
No. You shouldn't play RuneScape because it's a worse game than Eve, and that is a bar to clear.
Yeah. Alright, so you played a bunch of Japanese import games. What is attractive about those games if you don't like puzzles?
Well, I mean, like, there's a lot of them that don't have puzzles. Like, you know, here's the thing, you play Persona 3, you're going around and, hey, look, it's Japanese high school shit, and then... Oh, look, they have to shoot themselves in the head to do things. No, I'm dead serious. This is like a plot point. Like, hey, look, we have an extra hour in the day. Let's go shoot ourselves, summon monsters, and beat the shit out of things.
I've never played it, but that sounds amazing.
It sounds amazing, but it really isn't. You really shouldn't play.
Oh.
I know, it's kind of disappointing.
I don't know how that would be disappointing, but... It says because the world needed a pigeon-based dating sim...
No, if you've played that, and I have, it's amazing, and you should stream it.
What, The Hateful Boyfriend?
Yeah, it has a full boyfriend. It's amazing.
Oh, tell me about this. I have also, to hear about this.
It's Korean.
Korean? Okay. Explain this one to me. I'm interested in this game.
So, you are, as always, a new transfer student into a pigeon high school. And this is, like, basically, take your basic shitty Japanese dating sim and be like, hey, guess what? All the girls are now replaced with pigeons. Surprise!
What the fuck? Wow. Yeah, that's just... I don't even know what to say to the pigeon thing, man. Pigeons.
There's not much to say.
Fucking pigeons.
But there's also Akiba Strip, which is fun, which is literally go around Akibahara, you go and fight vampires, and to kill vampires, you have to expose them to the sun. And to expose them to the sun, you strip all their clothes off of them.
Japanese anime games in this chat.
Yep.
Wow, that is wonderful. Oh, man.
Yep.
Only on the boat show do we go into that topic.
I've tried
to watch people stream those games, and it just makes my eyes want to pop out my head. Like, I watched a girl try to stream a dating sim, and she was actually role-playing it so well. But imagine, instead of being a guy going after all the chicks, she was trying to pretend she was a lesbian going after all the chicks. And it was like, yeah, she was hot. It was hilarious because her boyfriend in the background is laughing his ass off. Like, he can't keep a straight face while she's seriously going, I'm going to get me a waifu. I'm just like, whoa. Woo.
You know what? I actually kind of miss living in Japan because then you can go and play these games in arcades with a crowd.
Oh, man. So someone just asked, why is there a Mick video feed? Well, as you all know from last week, I'm officially now sponsored by Blue Microphones. You can see it right here. It's right here. It's a Blue Microphone. So I couldn't find a way to take this microphone right here and put it on this camera right here. So I took my other camera, and I put it facing the microphone. So you get to see my cool microphone. It's so cool. I love this thing.
I'm not a good microphone. I'm just using the crap-ass piece of shit that came
with my I got to show you the one I had before, if I could find it. I don't know where it's at. But it was one of those $5 ones you get online that was made of plastic and a piece of wire. And the only reason the plastic's there is to hold it up.
Oh, you mean like my old microphone that was now duct tape?
Yes, this thing has electrical tape. I could have cracked in three places because I thought that's how you pulled it out. Really, you just
broke it.
So I've upgraded. Yeah, so.
This is why we can't have nice things.
No, it's not. So, would it be easier to put the picture of a blue microphone? No, you have to see that I have a. It's right there.
Oh,
you have to see it. But no. For some reason, sponsors like seeing their products on the stream, so I figured I'd show it. So back to games. How would you like to hear what I played this week?
Sure, go for it.
Eve.
Did you dump? Oh shit! So did I.
So much Eve this week. We invaded the region. For those of you that haven't been keeping up with Eve things, we went and invaded a region. We invaded Providence, and so I have been busy. So much. Right now, with bombing stuff. Just bombing everything. Like today, we threw 5 bombs and went home. And I don't even think we killed anything. Maybe a Naga or something. But we just played a lot of Eve. Oh, by the way, Kismetier says hi, and he says Jessica says hi. Oh, man.
Freaking nerds.
Kismetier is amazing.
Do you not remember this from the one time you went to
Yes! Well, I've been to Madison twice now, haven't I? Once when I was fat, and once when I was skinny.
Before me.
Yeah, I went there once when I was fat, and then I went there once when I was skinny. And it was hilarious, the difference.
Was fat.
Okay, technically, I'm fat, but,
Boat, you collapse wormholes behind you.
So yeah, when it comes to games, that's literally all I've played this week. I was supposed to play... was supposed to play a game with my girlfriend this week, but my best friend was in town. I mean, I played some PS3 games, but I don't want to talk about those. I was really bad at them. I died a lot. It really sucks. Yeah, it was terrible. But yeah, so, dear viewers, all you lovely people in the chat, would you do me a favor and just spam the chat with the games that you play? Now, if I cannot talk about the games, I'm sure Solus could, especially if it's Japanese waifu games. I'm pretty sure he has some expertise on the subject. So just list the games that you have. I mean, I did play Dark Souls yesterday, I guess. I forgot about that. Yeah, I extended my death streak to 21 more deaths, so... Soccer Cars! I played Soccer Cars.
I kind of want to play Soccer Cars, but I don't want to pay for Soccer Cars.
I got it for free, so I played it on the PS3. Yes. Borderlands pre-sequel, I hear they're making a movie about that game.
Really?
Yeah, Borderlands Lion Gate just bought the rights to it.
Huh.
Battlefield 4, I am terrible at that game because I try to suicide all the time. Eve and fuck Eve, a lot of Eve players. Metal Gear Solid Zero, Ground Zeroes. How do you have Ground Zeroes? Is that like where you blow up the Twin Towers in each country and then each country has their own Twin Towers?
Damn it, Bone! You said you would go there! But
they said Ground Zeroes, so I'm thinking there's like multiple sites. Maybe he beats Hiroshima and Nagasaki, you know, Ground Zeroes.
Yeah, take that. That's what you get for putting out the shitty waifu games.
We haven't even got... Oh my god. We are 10 minutes into the stream, ladies and gentlemen, and this is where we're going. Woo! Right down the drain. It's just... Oh, man.
Oh god, shit.
So, Duck Game. I tried Duck Game. I'm terrible at Duck Game. I quit Duck Game. That game must exist already. No, it actually doesn't. You can't nuke another country in any game I've ever played. They don't let you. It's not fair.
Well, you've never played Civ.
Well, that's different. I'm talking about, like a Sims kind of game. You can't just, like, go over and detonate a bomb. And down
Sims
goes the apartment building.
Nuclear Annihilation.
Yes!
Play the shit out of that.
The Sims version of what do they call it?
DEFCON?
Fallout.
Oh, okay.
The Sims Fallout, but before the war, so you get to detonate the apartment complex. Neighbors are being dicks. Kaboom!
That's what you get for letting your dog shit on my lawn.
Stupid noisy ass neighbors upstairs.
Thermonuclear revenge.
Wow. All right. Well, that's a great start to the show. So now that we've talked about video games, tell us a little bit, tell us who you are and a little bit about yourself.
Well, right now, I'm horribly broke and a bartender. So, you know, good times. I get free beer, so I can't complain too much about that. I also, drive part-time for Uber, and I'm a freelance writer. If you want to pay me to write your terrible Mittens and Boat fanfiction, I will totally do it. No, seriously, dude. Like, here's the thing. I'm going to get good at writing shitty porn, and I'm going to sell out. I'm going to write for Harlequin, and I'm going to live the life of luxury on top of a stack of shitty porn that I wrote. And you know what? I'm going to be goddamn proud of it.
You know, the people that write those probably are really proud of their shitty porn. They probably go to their grandparents, "Hey, Grandpa, look what I did today." I wrote a fanfic about an animal and a person. The animal's name was Sheep.
No. But
no, that's shit.
I'm aiming for the Canada market, so I'm going on man on bear action. And did you know that the novel Bear, which is literally just Canadian bear porn, is like one of their biggest classic novels?
No, I didn't know that. Any Canadians in the chat that can help me out here?
Yeah.
Wow. Alright, so freelance writing, bartending. I know you from EVE Online. But
yep.
What brought you to EVE Online?
So, this is going to be a fun story. It also kind of ends with might have been somewhat my fault for Mittens telling a guy to kill himself and getting kicked from the CSM. So, I was actually planning to go to that fan fest with a bunch of people from my LoSec corporation, and then all of them bailed, and because, like, two of them didn't have passports because they're lazy sacks of shit. And I'm like, well, okay, fine, I don't want to go by myself. Fuck it, I have a Something Awful account and 13 posts. And so I joined Dunwoff, and I was in Iceland the next week with Mittens and Kismetir and Archimede and all the rest of them. Mm-hmm. And then, I think it was the day before the panel, Mittens, Vile Rat, Kismetir, his wife, and I all met at a fish and chips place to discuss the content of his speech. And when he got to the part about telling the guy, the Wiz, to kill himself, he's like, I don't know, I don't think I should leave this in here. He was the only one against that part of the speech. Yeah, I was all for it, Vile Rat was all for it, Kismetir and his wife were like, yeah, it'll be cool, leave it in, it'll be funny, everybody will laugh. Well, everybody did laugh, I kinda laughed. The next day, the day he was going to do the panel, he walks out of the hotel with me, he's like, man, I don't feel like actually drinking today. I'm like, well, go fuck yourself. Don't be a pussy, and I bought him a beer. And that's how I may have had a hand in Mittens losing that 10,058.
Wow. Yeah. So you're that guy.
Okay. Surprise!
Surprise! Okay. So that's an interesting start to Eve. That's a lot more interesting than my start to Eve, though. Wow. All right, so what is your first video game that you can remember as a kid?
Super Mario.
Okay, who introduced you to that game?
My brother, who is an asshole.
Your asshole brother.
And he used me as basically like, hey, you're player two, go do the things I need you to do.
So you were the Tails to the Sonic.
More or less.
Yeah.
And then the next game I played was Super Metroid, and that was much better. I play that game all the friggin' time still, and I actually try to get into speedrunning it, and then there's people who are so much better than me, so I'm like, okay, I'm gonna speedrun a different game.
I've only ever played the Super Metroid for the what do they call that thing, Game Boy Advance? I downloaded a mod for it and played that one, where you get, like, the Dark Samus and the Light Samus.
Yeah, you mean Fusion? Yes.
Fusion, yes! And I played that, and that was fun.
Yeah, I played that when I was, like, 7 or 8, and that shit was scary to me as a child.
Yeah, I tried to, quote-unquote, speedrun it by doing a complete playthrough, and did it in 4.5 hours, and then I looked at the speedrun record, it was 59 minutes, and I'm like,
that is really fucking slow.
Yeah, I was like, oh, yeah, there's no way I'm going any faster. Someone said you should speedrun Castlevania. No, you should speedrun Japanese Dating Waifu. I don't think anyone's ever done it. Could you imagine, like, applying to Good Games Done Fast, being the only one in the category, and being like, how fast can I pick up a waifu and see? Could you imagine the amount, like, could you imagine going to Speed Demo Archives, like, annual thing, you know, Good Games Done Quick, and, like, one of the set goals would be, like, to get this waifu, or that waifu, or this waifu, and then have, like, bidding wars over a waifu.
No, there would be bidding wars, too. There would absolutely
yes!
be waifu bidding
yes!
wars.
Yes! You know how much money you could raise for that company? Right here. I am the manager. I will manage you, and boom, done.
All right, we got this boat. I
yes!
will run Japanese data games.
I guarantee the chat's going, abort, abandoned ship, what the hell are we getting involved in here? Oh man, I love the boat show, man. I have such unique guests.
This is so
I love
terrible.
Doing this. But I love it. I love doing it. This is why. So, alright, so your first game with your brother. Now, who got you the system? Was like, did your brother already have it and you just kind of like came along like you were the younger brother? Or
I legitimately don't remember, because I think we got the Super Nintendo when I was like 3 or 4. And I don't remember anything from that.
I'm not even answering that question, what is your favorite waifu? I don't have a waifu. I have my girlfriend, and that's where I leave it.
Waifu is hefty.
Though she did make a joke. She did make a joke last week or the week before, where she's like, I'm going to buy you a waifu pillow. I'm like, I'll beat you with it until you beat senseless. And she's like, okay, never mind that idea.
That's feel like I'm going to go on to Mumble after this, and I'm going to start taking up a collection to send you a waifu pillow.
Okay, okay, yeah, I have some questions for you, now that we're getting to that. Thank you, Porkbutt, for reminding me.
Oh, God.
I have two questions. One, I was told to ask you... Let me find it here real quick.
I know exactly where this is going. I can already tell you to fuck up.
Let me find it. Fuck, I can't find it. Anyways, the one question was, is it true you're the Cylon? Or you are a Cylon?
So all the people who play Battlestar Galactica with me, I'm drunk, you really shouldn't give me the loyalty deck because I have a habit of stacking the deck to make myself a Cylon.
Hello, Coffin Mate.
Cheats.
So you make yourself a Cylon. So that was one of the questions. And then someone else asked me a question about you being drunk, but I can't remember the exact phrase that they asked. I'm trying to find it. They said, make sure you ask him something about being drunk. Hang on, let me control F, find it. Cylon. Ah, here we go. Wait. No, he said he was a Cylon. That doesn't count. Maybe it was a Cyclops?
Maybe
he asked me on Jabber. I don't remember. Anyways, the question came up is, were you a Cylon and something about you being intoxicated? It was from K-Color.
Oh. Fucking, I don't know. K-Color has no room to speak. He's a Canadian. Canadians are always Cylons.
Always? No,
absolutely. Like, fucking K-Color, every time he played, he was a Cylon. Fucking Gallic, every time he played, he was a Cylon. Fucking Cylons are always Canadians. If you see a Canadian, they're not real people. They're Cylons.
If they're Canadian, they're not real people. Wow, okay. I was not the Cylon, but people seemed to think I was because I was being too serious. I don't know what the case was. That game was weird.
It's a fun game.
Okay, so bartending. Why bartending?
Because I like the beer there.
You like the beer there. So you drink there a lot, and all of a sudden, you're a bartender.
More or less. I mean, my brother actually knows the wife of the owner, so I'm like, hey, get me a job there. I'm like, okay. Because I was planning on just having a short-term job for like the next couple months or so because I'm just waiting on the state police because I'm going to join the Michigan State Police. I'm waiting on Academy. And then Michigan can't budget for shit, so Academy's like, next fucking year, surprise. I'm not bitter at all.
No, of course not. So, have you ever thought about attending the Bartending Olympics? Like, international bartenders, like the best bartenders out there that flip the bottles and all that stuff.
See, you can't really do that with beer, though, because then you'll ruin the beer, it'll fizz all over. That said, I did do a lot of bartending liquor in Japan, because one of my friends was independently wealthy and owned a bar and never actually wanted to bartend, so he's like, hey, you want to get free drinks? Make your own drinks? Go stand behind the bar, make people drinks. But it's fun. I have literally zero expectations set upon me, and you know what? I managed to meet or exceed those zero expectations.
Wonderful. So you say you live in Japan. What was that like?
Japan was fun. It was, I did not live on mainland Japan, so I didn't have to deal with all the fucking weeb shit, which was nice. I lived in Okinawa, which was basically tropical island paradise, except in the summer when you walk out and it's 105 degrees and you're immediately coated with sweat. And then you have to go out into the plane and work in the plane. It's really fucking hot in the plane because the air conditioning never works in the back of the plane. Fuck the pilots.
So why do you say fuck the pilots, though? Is it their fault?
Because they sat up front. See, I was a loadmaster. I was in the back half of the C-130 where the air conditioning didn't work. The pilots and the engineer and the navigators were in the front half in the flight deck where the air conditioning did work.
Oh, you had to deal with that bullshit.
Yeah. It's okay. I got to do the fun jobs. I got to push people out of planes.
Really? Got to push people? Like actual people or...
Yeah, like actual people, unless you're like not counting Koreans as people, but, you know, racist.
Oh, wow. Okay, we can't go there. So, next topic. Why'd you leave the military?
Mostly because I wanted to go and do school and do something better with my life. Surprise, this was a poor decision. I really did enjoy the military.
I almost did military. I did ROTC for 4 years and then was like, yeah, no, fuck this. They told me I had to shave this all the time and it wasn't really,
Oh yeah, you had to shave. I forgot you have a friggin' goatee.
Yeah. They told me I couldn't have this, I had to have a certain hairstyle, I had to dress up once a week, and I was just like, yeah, no, fuck that. I had so many suspensions for that shit, and so much trouble for that, I don't even want to go into it. But, yeah.
That is an amazing mental picture, you and ROTC.
Yeah, I almost went to the Air Force Academy on a full scholarship, and,
oh, God. No. Four years of that shit.
Well, that was that wouldn't have been too bad. I mean, it would have been a collegiate scholarship. So he wants to. They want to know.
Air Force Academy.
Were you Navy, Marines, Army, or Air Force?
What?
Which branch? Military.
Oh, I was Air Force.
Air Force. Okay.
Yep. Nice. Air Force, because you know I don't feel like being out of boat, and I don't feel like being dumb or.
I don't feel like being shot. That's why I was going Air Force.
I got shot at in the Air Force.
What?
Yeah.
No way. If you don't mind sharing, I mean, that would be a cool story.
All right, so there's not really too much to this story. Like, the Philippines has a surprising Al-Qaeda terrorist presence. You'd never guess it, but they do. And so we were rolling down the runway on takeoff, and apparently some idiot is at the end of the runway, like, just past the fence with an AK, spraying at our plane, and I didn't even notice until I heard something clank. And I didn't even think anything of it until we came back, finished the mission, came back around. Turns out that's a bullet hole, and security force had said, beaten the shit out of that guy already.
Oh, wow.
I didn't even realize I had gotten shot at.
That's amazing. So, you didn't even realize they're gonna have a bullet hole in your leg, and you'd be like, hey, where did this come from, man? Thought the plane broke or some shit?
I'm pretty sure I had a whole leg at one point.
A whole leg? Alright, so speaking of military and that, what game are we playing this week, my friend here? What game?
Boats!
We are playing boats.
Boat on the boat show.
We are playing boats on the boat show, baby! One of our viewers says he was Army 8 years in UGG, Philippines. I don't know about the Philippines. It seems like a great destination for a vacation.
Yeah, I was never stationed in the Philippines. I did TDYs to the Philippines, which were amazing.
Yeah.
Then I got per diem.
So we're going to be playing boats. I think we're going to start with an Atlanta and the Sims. Are you okay with that?
Yeah, I'm good with that.
Okay. I'm bad at boats. My goal is to suicide endlessly, so that's what we're going to do. I'm going to make this as terrible as possible.
So, you know, standard fare.
Boats, who is your favorite boat girl? I can't answer that question because I don't know how to answer that. They're saying that the Philippines is cheap prostitutes in wet weather. Or wet weather. Yeah. I don't know what wet weather is. I guess the prostitutes get wet weather. I guess they take America to a whole new level. You know, that's like, I remember a friend in college. He looked at me and goes, let me guess, your girlfriend be like Awkwafina. She makes that wet wet. I'm like, and I'm just looking at him going, did she just say that? She looks at me.
Ashamed of that joke.
Well, no, she looks at me at the time and goes, what? She couldn't speak the language. So. Oh, man. So, hey, we're about 27 minutes of the show or so. I want to thank everyone for tuning in today. And if you really, really enjoy this stream, which apparently a lot of the active talking people do, you can follow the stream below. There's a little button down this way. There's also a subscribe button if you really like it. Hey, Boat, your chroma key. What about my chroma key? Is it working? Oh, it's not working! Ah, I broke it! Help!
Hold on. Oh, God, did you break it again?
No, I always break everything on this damn show.
There's
a reason they have me being the resident DJ. So there's a way to fix it. It's easy. Watch this. Right? Click a button. Oh, shit. We're starting. Oh, dear.
Yeah, we're starting. I still haven't loaded in.
There. I fixed it. I think I fixed it.
Why haven't I loaded in?
Boat turns blank into California. Wow. Boat turns shit into California. Oh, man. That's good. All right. So I'm in Atlanta, for those of you interested in watching. There's Solus, and he is in a Sims. Now, I was warned beforehand to watch out for friendly fire. I really hope that's not the case.
That will totally be the case.
Oh, dear.
If I actually load into this game,
holy
shit.
So we have a Sims, and we have a Atlanta. Now, a Sims is a Golden Destroyer, and I'm playing the Golden Cruiser, because, well, it's gold.
Come on. You can do it, kid. You can load. I want to play.
It shows you there.
Yeah, no, I'm looking at you. I'm going to restart boats and then see how this goes.
No tirpitz. What the hell is a tirpitz? I don't even think they have tirpitz in this. Just don't go broadside. Oh, I'm going to go broadside as long as he torpedoed me. I'm a little worried that he'll torpedo me.
I will totally torpedo you.
Use the island knee motor. Use the islands to knee motor. I don't know what that means, but...
I don't understand what a knee motor is either.
What? I don't understand what a knee motor is. Is that where you, like, strap a fucking motor around your knee and walk around going, Allah!
What the hell?
I'm just curious. I don't know. I'm asking. Shoot the islands, they say. Shoot over the islands, they're saying. Okay, shoot over the islands. There we go.
I don't know. I think shooting the islands is possibly your best course of action here.
You just gotta be careful because, there's this one island on this map that has people with bows and arrows, and they'll kill you. The Indian Ocean, you know what I'm talking about? That's a scary place, man. I don't want to go there. Oh, sorry. The Allah joke came from the Alliance tournament. Camel Empire from EVE Online was in the Alliance tournament. And they're, one of their things, they scream Allah really loud. And it's like carries on for like 5 minutes. It's amazing.
So it's basically like a Ah Chain except Allah Chain.
Yeah, it's like, And there's like 10 guys with like 10 camels. And they're like screaming. And it's like a war cry or something like that. But it's fucking amazing. It's like the best ad of any ad I've ever seen for something.
Ugh. Oh, I haven't actually seen any of the Alliance tournament other than, like, the first weekend. I watched... Yeah. Who was it that, like, launched the bombs and annihilated the other team, like, within 30 seconds of starting, and it was amazing.
Another island is hit. So, right now, guys, we are traveling. I haven't played this game in, like, a month. It's really bad. So, we're gonna go charging at this Abuki. Now, Abukis, or Abikis, are Tier 9 destroyers, or cruisers, and they'll probably kill me.
I was loaded into boats earlier today. What is this
Wait,
shit?
Wait, there's a Tirpitz? They got the Tirpitz in this game? Oh, yeah, man, look at that.
Bismarck's like gonna be the one that you can grind to.
Boat is not gay. He is just optimistic. Yeah, no, I am very optimistic. Yeah, a lot of people confuse my hyperness for drugs or my hyperness for flamboyance. But definitely not that.
Speaking of, did you hear Billy is back? I was so excited.
Yes. Yes, yes, coke will flow from the heavens.
Dude, I was so excited that
he has seen all week. It's been great. Yeah, it's been great. Oh, tier 8 premium battleship. Okay.
Time to kill it.
Are you in?
Yeah, I'm finally in. It finally worked.
Go blow them up. I'm going after this New Mexico here. So, guys, we're going to use a round called a high explosive round. And it's a really bad round for fighting anything really important. But we're doing it because we can, and it really pisses off these guys like here. See this battleship? It's really going to piss him off when he gets hit with these rounds.
It's a bad round, but armor piercing is worse.
Yeah, well, I just set him on fire, so it's really going to tick his day.
Rip him.
Yeah, really, it's going to be a rip him in a second. I don't know if you're charging down the middle or anything. There's a ship down the middle.
I'm charging up to you because I can't really torpedo you for more than 5.5 kilometers away.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Good point. You're going to have to get a little closer than that to torpedo. So we're going to shoot this guy. Wait, can we buy the Tirpitz? Yeah, I would buy the Tirpitz just to look at, but I don't want to spend gold. You can always fire on the Atlanta. Well, I could, but I'm in Atlanta.
No, I mean... He's saying you always fire AG.
Oh, yeah, you're a flamethrower on this motherfucker. Damn right. Yeah. Oh, fuck, we're dying because the Abuki's looking at me funny.
I haven't even been shot.
Goddamn Abuki. I hate those things. They're so broken. Like, I don't know if you ever played this game, but the Abuki is... It's like a destroyer killer or cruiser killer. I mean, look at this. He is wrecking my ass.
I bet you lots of people do that.
Wow. I don't even know where to go with that comment.
Battle yet.
We just got into the damn game and you're already making those jokes.
Yeah.
Fuck. Whatever, I'm gonna set this guy on fire. He's already on fire in one place, so let's keep firing at him. So we're trying our best not to die in this game, ladies and gentlemen, because I am terrible. NA server is so neglected. I wouldn't call it neglected as much as it's a Russian company. What do you expect? Like, they put in Russian premium battleships. The Russian Navy was a World War I rust bucket that I don't even think functioned during World War II.
No, no, they did function. They took the Russian Navy all the way around, like, the Horn of Africa to bring it to Japan for World War II. They managed to fire on the British Navy while doing so, lost two ships to friendly fire, couldn't fire during firing exercises because there were snakes wrapped around the friggin' guns. And then they arrived into the Sea of Japan and got absolutely fucking dunked by the Japanese Navy.
Why do I find this so surprising?
It really isn't. I mean, like, the Russian Navy is...
Wow, we actually might win this, and I'm not going to get torpedoed by friendlies. All right.
The hell you ain't.
This is good. This is good. I'm alive. Nice and safe. Comfortable. I should need my flamethrower. The problem is, I don't think I'm going to hit. Like, I'm trying to hit. Yeah, I'm too short.
I don't even know where my shells are. I'm shooting at this New Mexico.
Oh god. Oh god, they're looking at me funny! Oh god. This fucking Ibuki is like looking at me funny. I don't like it. Oh, here we go, I might hit this guy! Woohoo! Yay! Set him on fire now!
Oh god, I'm getting shot!
Oh god, what are you getting shot by?
The Mogami.
Alright, I'm gonna help you with it. I got your back.
Sweet. I don't think he's going to appreciate what I'm about to do to him.
We're going to turn him into a pillow. That's the only thing I don't get about Japanese culture. They come up with some of the weirdest fucking shit.
I can tell you exactly where that came from. Cultural repression that came in post-World War II. They're like, oh, really? We have to be so proper and all that stuff and censor all the genitals. Well, surprise, when you do all that, people be like, hey, let's get into some freakier shit that's not censored.
But
that
the
is
funny
exactly
thing,
what happened in Japan.
But see, what's crazy about that, though, is that when you think about Japan, they're always so formal in the business sense, and, like, pornography has to be censored, and all this stuff, yet we get waifu pillows. I mean...
There is a phrase. It is, senpai in the streets, hentai in the sheets.
Oh my god. You're not serious, are you?
No, it's not actually.
Nippon shaming. No, I'm not Nippon shaming. I love Japan. I'm actually wanting to go to Japan. But it's just one of those things where when you look at their culture, it's scary.
Yep.
But that's just me. I'm a teacher. I have to deal with this. Like, it's okay in Japanese culture to have a thing for your brother that's like 50 years older than you. It's kind of spooky.
All right, Boat. Let me tell you the thing about Japan, though, that will absolutely sell you on Japan.
Uh-huh.
Beer and vending machines.
What about vending machine?
Beer and vending machines.
Did you say urine?
I guess probably in some places, but no, I said beer.
Oh, beer!
Yes.
Oh.
I guess, like, yeah, I feel like somebody has probably tried and put urine in vending machines, but...
No, I'll be honest, I'm dead. I want to go to a Japanese bathhouse, like a bathhouse-type hotel, spring hotel or whatever.
Oh yeah, those are fun.
I've been to a Russian one, I've been to a Turkish one, and those are amazing. Now, you sequenced in the Atlanta. See, the Atlanta's interesting because I'm terrible with it, so...
Oh, God, my engine's broken again. I need that to go fast.
There's Solus right over there.
Sinking and dying.
Let's get over here and have a look at our friend here. There he is. Right in the Siams. Why don't you throw smoke up?
Oh, because I already used it.
Rip. All right, let's get the other ship. We just died.
Oh, you died too?
Yeah, I've been dead. I'm terrible.
Oh, okay. Tier 4 is like the actual highest tier I have.
Tier? That's perfect. I'll do a tier 4.
Sweet.
I don't know which tier 4 I'm going to do, but I'll do a tier 4. Somebody messaged me. Rhino Cavill. Okay, I don't know why he messaged me, but he did. So tier 4, I could use this ship. The Grimachi.
I know for a fact that's not even close to how it's pronounced, but it's Russian, and I'm not willing to try.
Grimachi or whatever it's called? I don't fucking know. Yeah, exactly. It's Russian. Who cares?
Yeah,
it's
I'm
a ship.
I'm not even going to try.
It's got bolts and screws, and it floats, okay? That's all it needs to know.
No, dude.
Oh, that's you. Hi.
So, I want to see in World of Boats that spherical Russian battleship. They had a Russian battleship that was friggin' round, and it was amazing. I want that in Boats.
Yeah, I am not sure that would be compatible with this game. But the good news is, they have a Bogue, we have a Ryujo, I've got torpedoes. End of story. I've got motherfuck. Now they have six fucking Clevelands. What the fuck?
Six this is your fault, Bogue! Cleveland. This is your fault, you asked for this!
That's not fair! And we're playing on the open ocean map! Oh, fucking Christ. I probably said that on Liza's stream and forgot. What? Oh god. Oh god. Go ship, go. See how fast you can go. Hit the turbo boosters.
Not fast enough to not die!
The mighty Russian flag. So this ship, it actually has a really cool, like, smokehouse looking thing. This would be a cool ship to sail the high seas on, to be honest with you. But I'd have to do it without the guns. This would make a cool yacht. It just looks like it'd be a yacht, you know? I mean, of course, without the mines and the explosives and the torpedo launchers, but... I'm from Higgle Academy. What?
I don't even know what that is.
You do what? I think they were talking military speak, and I don't know anything about the military. So... That is interesting, though. So, why the state police... Of all the police departments you could do, DEA, FBI, local, why stateies?
Well, actually, the three-letter agencies require you to have a college degree already. I ran out of money with the GI Bill because I swapped majors midway through, which was honestly a pretty bad decision. So I don't have a degree. The reason that I don't pick any of the other police places in the state is because they require you to pay for your own way through the academy. Oh, there are two places in the state of Michigan that will pay your way through the police academy. They are the Michigan State Police and the Detroit Police. Okay. Gonna be frank, there's really not much of a choice there.
Yeah, I don't know if I'd want to be Detroit Police either. The amount of... Oof.
No,
you wouldn't. But if I wanted a desk job or maybe worked in homicide, I'd have a good guaranteed job, you know?
I don't know, man. Like, see, have you ever seen a unicorn?
No.
And you've never seen a Detroit state, the Detroit cop either.
Yes, but I'm pretty sure they have plenty of homicide detectives.
I feel like you're overestimating them a bit. I feel like they should have a bunch of homicide detectives.
I see. Competence level is higher than, expectation level is higher than competence, I see. Oh,
yeah,
shit! Hey! Oh, shit! There's a ship in front of me! Oh, shit!
Don't die, boat!
Oh, no, I'm not trying to. I'm gonna shoot him. Oh, fuck. Torpedoes.
What's the range on torpedoes on that thing?
I don't fucking know. 20 fucking... 10K, roughly, it looks like.
Oh, that's actually pretty good. You know, if you hold control and, like, mouse over the, like, little gun or torpedo icon, it'll tell you how long it is.
I don't know, I just got one blown up. 8 kilometers.
Oh, okay.
Apparently one just got blown up.
Nice.
There's a Fubuki here. Oh god, in the Cleveland.
Run, boat!
Trying to go into my smoke screen, but I'm on... Oh god.
Run, boat!
Fuck. I'm just gonna launch the torpedo tubes now, just because my engine got cut. Out of my own smoke screen.
Rip boat.
Really, game? Really? Is that how we're going to treat me today?
Well, I mean, like, you're in your own smoke screen, so I guess it could
be. Yeah, but I can't repair for 30 seconds, and I have no engine out of the shore.
Also, those guys all seem to be missing you terribly. Oh, wait, nope, they stopped missing.
Okay, that guy did a turn. He's not supposed to turn. He's supposed to go straight, so my torpedoes will hit him. That's not fair.
This is why you can't have nice things.
That's why I'm bad at this game. Well, good news is I'm stopping. And there's a torpedo coming at me. And I can't repair for 10 seconds. Okay, well. That's definitely about to happen. Hey, I repaired! Woo! Go fast,
run,
bud!
Run, run!
No! Do a Yui! Oh god, oh god, oh god.
I see that.
Oh shit! Oh shit! Help! Help!
I'm
dying!
Running,
God. Boat, stop shooting. They can't see you. Yeah, they can. I'm not in smoke. But I did do a U-turn. And I'm not dead yet.
I think you might have gotten away.
No, I'm going to have to do like some crazy Ivans and shit. Oh, you're right. I think I might have gotten away.
Don't get drift shit in boats.
Good. They're going to shoot you instead of me. You son of a bitch! I had the same thought that you're gonna die and I'm gonna live! Ha-ha!
You rat bastard, Boat!
Victory!
I'm still alive, motherfucker!
I got guns.
I had more torps.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, shit, you
can't aim with shit.
Yes! Yes!
Oh, that's not fair. I wasn't fair. I wasn't prepared to shoot you yet. God damn it.
Now
you can detect shooting
AWOL
on smoke. Oh, man. So rude.
You got outvoted.
Alright. Alright, well, while you're busy dying, we'll look over your dead Hulking corpse.
Carrying the team?
Oh, that was so fucked up. Why'd you kill me? Like, I knew you were gonna torpedo me. I knew that was coming. Like, I immediately turned my torpedoes and started shooting. I knew it was coming. But, I really didn't expect to die.
Oh, that was good shit.
Alright, I gotta find you. Are you still alive? Stop letting me, like, zoom in on you. Hold on. Show me my killer, stupid game.
I can't believe I actually killed you with Japanese destroyer guns.
Yeah, I don't even know how you did that.
Magic!
Wow, it's not letting me zoom in on you.
It was the power of my waifu!
Oh, wow. Like, I'm trying to zoom in on you, it's not letting me? That's kind of weird.
If you, like, click control and then click my... Hold control and click my name in the upper left-hand corner, you should be able to do it.
There we go. Fucking magic. Alright, launch your torpedoes and blow people up.
That's what I'm doing, getting close. Gonna knife fight him.
Now, you have 4 torpedo tubes? Or
I
6?
I have 3 torpedo tubes. Oh god, I'm being shot.
Fire the torpedoes!
I'm turning!
I shot plenty of planes down as the destroyer has. Then I stopped trying, assuming it made me visible. It does make you detectable shooting planes down. Yep. As far as I know.
Oh god!
Well, you're fucking dead.
Yep.
Next ship!
Rip.
Oh man. I haven't played boats in a while, I see why. This is definitely an interesting game when it gets fun. Like, doing that right there, those suiciding ops. Hey, by the way, our team lost.
Surprise!
You know. So, hey, if you have any questions for Solus in the chat, if you're watching, if you have any questions, go ahead and feel free to ask them.
I will feel free to ignore them! DJ Request ain't take no requests!
Wow. So you're the guy at the Goomp this year that made Scion immediately go, have this guy on the show, it is worth it. Why do you think Scion recommended you?
Because every time I've been at the Goomps, I've apparently been the center of attention because I love being the center of attention.
Right. And that's what I remember.
Yeah, I mean, you were there, he's messy.
I feel I need to be in his corp. What corp are you in?
I'm in fucking... Waff or Whole Squad. Because fucking Whole Squad is on that real shit!
So they slur penis. Gotcha. Okay. Your chroma key is fuzzy again. I'm not worried about the chroma key. Fuck it. I'll fix it later. So someone says...
Nothing ticket to the fucking bottom of the sea.
So this guy, insane, yeah. If you want to get an SA account, post a lot, and then join Waff. Just be careful of... deposits. It's kind of expensive.
Or you could just, you know, join Karma Fleet, have to deal with the terribleness that is Reddit, and be there immediately. That said, though, apparently you only need, like, 13 posts to join WAF, because that's all I had. That said, it was in the Battletech threads making fun of some Spurg and making him absolutely lose his shit. It was a lot of fun.
So if you ever watch the stream, by the way, if you ever watch these streams, DudeCalm is the leader of Whole Squad, I think, and he streams for Whole Squad, and
that's... Did you just call him DudeCalm?
DudeCalm, that's what I call him, DudeCalm. But anyways, DudeCalm, he is, so when you ever watch that stream, you'll see Solus there a lot.
Yep.
Karma Fleet is best fleet. I don't know about that.
Well, now they have three now. Obviously, they're the best fleet.
Yeah, I don't know if that would quantify the term best. I could say they are definitely Brave-esque, but...
Oh, those are harsh words, man.
Well, no, Brave wasn't too bad during their era of listening to Pork Butt.
And then they let
Estin. Oh.
Yeah, why do you think Brave devolved into a clusterfuck of drama and hilarity? Because Test joined them.
Well, there was that one time. At band camp. So what we're doing right now, guys, we're flying this this ship called the Atlanta, and we're going to charge in there. Karma Fleet is not classy. No, they're definitely not classy. The last time I had a Karma Fleet guy on an op, it kind of scared me. I cringed.
I think we have the one cool Karma Fleet guy in Whole Squad, and then the rest of the Karma Fleet guys in Whole Squad are still Karma Fleets of those guys.
Karma Fleet tends to be a sore subject with me sometimes because Porkbutt's such a cool dude, and he steals all my renters. So that's like the only downside to the Karma Fleets. Hey! Watch where you're going. Watch where you're going. I'm trying to shoot this Cleveland.
Watch where I'm going.
We're gonna shoot a Cleveland. Help me out here. We're gonna blow it up. We're gonna actually try and win a game.
What? Those are some strange words. Win.
Win. Victory. Yeah. I know those are difficult to come by, but we're gonna try.
I hit him, so I'll take that.
He's getting a lot of damage. I just don't know if it's from me or you.
It sure as shit is not from me.
No, you're about to hit the rocks. Congratulations.
I am hitting the rocks right now. But you know what? I'm behind the rock.
One gun at a time, boat, that'll take your guns out. I'm not worried about my guns. I don't care if I die. Hold down your button to fire. No, why would I hold it down? I like going pew-pew! Like that. Oh, I know what the viewers want me to do. They want me to make it like a fucking machine gun. Watch this.
Yeah, they want you to do the ripple fire instead of salvo fire. You know what I have to say to that? Screw them.
No, it's okay. I see what they're saying to do. I'll do it. I'll blow this guy up with it.
Mutsuki!
Oh god, torpedoes.
Kill it.
I'm about to kill a Cleveland, I think, which will be a kind of an achievement. Yep. Wreck, nerds! Oh fuck.
You're about to get wrecked, nerd!
No, I'm trying to shoot my torpedoes, but it's lagging, like, really badly all of a sudden. I don't know what the hell just happened.
Rip boat!
Oh, I'm dead. I don't know what happened. Like, the game lagged out.
The jump button was next to the bridge button.
Hey, I killed a guy. What have you done?
I'm gonna go kill Tector. Oh god, is that actually Tector? I'm gonna kill him.
Oh my god, that might be Tector. Holy shit, hold on.
That looks like Tector, I'm gonna kill him.